This is the problem on the solid slab bridges. This is given in your previous year 2017 question papers. Design a solid slab bridge for the class AA loading for the following data. Clear span we have 4.5 meter and clear width of the road is 7 meter. Average thickness of the bearing coat is 80 mm and use M20 and unit weight of concrete is 2400 Newton per meter cube and use Fe415. So, first of all, in first step we have to find out the permissible stresses. So, for permissible stresses, sigma CBC equal to 7 Newton per mm square. How this 7 comes from? M20 divided by factor of safety of concrete in WSM. In WSM for concrete we use 3 for factor of safety and for steel we use 2.3 for factor of safety. So, M20 divided by 3, that is 7. Sigma is t equal to 190 Newton per mm square. How is come out? 415 divided by 2.3, that is 190 Newton per mm square. So, modular ratio equal to 280 divided by 3 sigma CBC, that is 280 divided by 2 into 7, 13.33. Similarly, 13 is the modular ratio. K equal to modular ratio sigma CBC, modular ratio sigma CBC plus sigma ST, that is 13 into 7 plus 190, that is we have 0.3238. J equal to 1 minus K by 3, we have 1 minus K equal to, that is 3238 divided by 3, we have 0.89 value of J. Value of Q equal to half into J into K into sigma CBC, that is we have 1.008. Okay. Second step, we have to find out the depth of the slab and effective span. So, generally the thickness we take in the slab is 80 per meter. Okay. So, overall thickness equal to 80 into we have the span length equal to 4.5, that is 80 into 4.5 meter, that is 360 mm. Overall thickness. So, we are providing thickness equal to 500. So, we are providing depth. This is the depth 500. Assume 25 mm dia bar and 25 mm clear cover. Effective depth equal to 50 minus 25 plus 25 divided by 2 equal to 462.5. This is the total depth. This is the thickness of the slab or total depth of the slab and this is the effective depth, that is the small d, 4.625 mm. Now, for effective span, clear span plus effective depth equal to 6 plus 0.462, that is 6.462 center to center of bearing. We have not given bearing, so we will going through this effective span 6.462. In next step, we have to draw the cross section of the bridge by the value we have assumed and value we have in the question by which we will draw the cross section of the bridges. So, the length is 8.2 meter. How it's come from 8.2, that is the, this is the 7 meter and 600 mm is the curve length and this is not given in the question, we have assumed. In question not given the size of the curve, assume curve equal to 600 mm. Curve is not given, so we have assumed that 600 mm and 600 mm, so we have added it this, so we get 8.2 meter as a whole length. So we have find out the slab thickness, this is the slab, so the thickness of the slab is 500 and this is the thickness of the curve, 300 mm. मतलब 300 mm कर्व इस सरफेस से अबव है एंड दिस इज द बियरिंग कोट ऑफ द रोड एंड दिस इज द थिकनेस ऑफ द बियरिंग कोट 80 mm TW क्रॉस सेक्शन ऑफ द डेक स्लैब. दिस इज द क्रॉस सेक्शन ऑफ द डेक स्लैब. इन स्टेप नंबर 4 वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द डेड लोड बेंडिंग मोमेंट्स. फर्स्ट डेड लोड ऑफ द स्लैब 24 इनटू d इनटू l, दैट इज वी हैव 24 एंड d इक्वल टू 0.5 and L equal to, we have taking length equal to 1 meter. So, 12 kilonewton per meter square. second wearing coat equal to gamma w into thickness into 1 meter. So we have gamma w equal to 22 into 0.08 meter into 1 equal to 1.76 kilonewton per meter square. So total load equal to 1 plus 2, that is 12, plus 1.76, that is 13.76 kilonewton. WD equal to 13.76 kilonewton. By the value of dead load, we will find out the bending moment by the dead load. So, bending moment equal to WD into L effective square divided by 8, 13.76 into 6.462 square divided by 8. M dead load equal to 70.4 kilonewton per meter, the bending moment by the dead load. In step number 5, we have to find live load and bending moment of that live load. For class AA tracked vehicles, impact factor equal to 25 minus 15 by 4, LE minus 5. We have 15 by 4, LE equal to 6.461. We have find out LE, the effective span length, minus 5. That is impact factor equal to 19.52%. Effective length of road equal to LR, LT plus 2 into TS plus TW. TS is thickness of the slab and TW is thickness of the wearing coat. LR equal to 3.6 plus 2 into 0.500 plus 0.8. LR equal to 4.76 meter. We have given in IRC loading condition for class A vehicles, we have the length of the vehicles equal to 3.6 meter. That is 3.6 meter, the length of track A vehicles we have 3.6 meter and this is the TS plus TW, thickness of slab plus thickness of wearing coat. This is the LR, effective length of the track. Now we have to find out the effective width of the slab. B equal to K into X into 1 minus XY LE plus VW. Diagram shows that we are calculating all parameters keeping the vehicles at the center of the span. That means जो हम calculate कर रहे हैं, जितना भी data ले रहे हैं, वो vehicles को center पर रख के, तो जो load है ऐसा मान के चल रहे हैं, जो हमारा track है, जो road है, उस पर vehicles at center पर चल रहे हैं, उसको parameter मान के हम लोग value use कर रहे हैं ये सारे formula में. Okay, so this is 4.6 meter LR, effective length of track. This is effective length of track LR, 4.6 meter. This is the whole length of the slab. K is the constant depending on the B by L ratio referring to table of code book, and for the simply supported slab K equal to 2.77. in this question we are going to use for K 2.77 value. X equal to 6.461 divided by 2, that is the half of the length of this effective length of slab, equal to 3.23. LE equal to effective length, that is 6.461 meter, and BW equal to width of the vehicles, so BV plus 2TW. BW equal to 0.85, that is the BV base length of the wheel, plus 2 into 0.08, this is the thickness of bearing coat. So VW equal to 1.01 meter. This is the base wheel, 850 given in the IRC loading. So this is our slab and this is the wheel length. This is wheel length, this is wheel length, and this is the gap between the two wheels. Okay, this is the B effective, the length, effective length of the road track, the effective length of the road track. So B equal to K, this is the K, 2.77 for simply supported slab, into 3.23, 1 minus 3.23 divided by 6.461 plus 1.01. So we have the value for BE, effective length of the track, 5.48 meter. For the total load of the two track with impact, that is, we have formula for total load for the track. 1 ton equal to 35 ton we have given. So 1 ton equal to 10 kilonewton. So that 350 kilonewton and 350 kilonewton 1. This is in the into sign, okay. 1 plus 0.1952. So we have the value of load on the track. That is 836.64 kilonewton. We have impact factor, this value 19.52%. So 0.1952 is the value for the impact factor. Average intensity of the load equal to load on the track divided by LR into BE. So we have 836.64 divided by 4.76 into 5.48 kilonewton per meter square. That is 35 kilonewton is the average. 35 kilonewton is the average intensity of the load. Maximum bending moment due to the live load, that is the M max equal to W into LR divided by 2 into X. X we have finded out the half length of the effective length of the span. W into LR divided by 2 into LR divided by 4. So we have W, this is W 35. LR equal to 4.76 divided by 2 into X is the 3.23 and W equal to 35 into 4.76 divided by 2 into 4.76 divided by 4. So we have maximum bending moment equal to 169.932 kilonewton. Similarly equal to 170 kilonewton. So total moment equal to moment by dead load plus moment by live load. So we have the load 240 kilonewton is the total moment coming on the slab or coming on the track. Now we will design for the shear. Step 6, shear due to the class AA track vehicles. Class AA track vehicle ke liye shear find karna hai. For maximum shear at the support IRC clause, AA track are the this loading. IRC kehta hai ki jo मैक्सिमम सीयर सपोर्ट पे होगा अगर ट्रैक पे व्हीकल्स का लोडिंग इस तरह से होगा तो सेंटर पे ना होके अगर कॉर्नर से लोडिंग होता है व्हीकल्स का मतलब व्हीकल्स यहाँ अगर प्लेस कर रहे हैं तो सबसे ज़्यादा सीयर डेवलप होगा सपोर्ट पे. दिस इज द लोड पोजीशन फॉर मैक्सिमम सीयर फोर्स. ओके तो वी हैव द एल इफेक्टिव इक्वल टू 6.461 मीटर एंड द एक्स एट विच X is 2.38 meter, that is the half of this vehicle's effective length. So this is the LR support and VA and support and VB. Now again effective width BE. BE हमें फिर से find करना है. BE equal to K into X. BE फिर से क्यों find करना है कि at that time व्हीकल्स कहाँ पे था? सेंटर पे था. हमने इस व्हीकल का ड्राइंग कहाँ पे किया था? सेंटर पे, मिडिल ऑफ द स्लैब ये व्हीकल्स लाई कर रहा था. ओके तो उस समय के लिए बी ई हमारा जो पहले वैल्यू आया था वो था. अब चूंकि व्हीकल्स हमारा कॉर्नर पे लाई कर रहा है और मैक्सिमम सीयर फोर्स सपोर्ट पे डेवलप हो रहा है इसलिए अब बी ई डिफरेंट हो जाएगा. सो इफेक्टिव विड्थ बी ई इक्वल टू के इंटू एक्स वन माइनस same formula we are using for the VE at the place of X. At that time we have used 3.28 and now we are using 2.38. This is the half length of this LR. So 2.7 the constant for the simply supported slab, K is the 2.38 this length and 1 minus 2.38 divided by LE 6.461 plus BW we have I think 1.01. So we have the value for 5.17 meter. So B equal to 5.17 meter. Now width of the dispersion of load equal to 2225 plus 2050 plus this length 5170 divided by 2. That is 6.86 meter. This is the width of the dispersion of load. From BE new value we have the load intensity W equal to हमने पहले के B से load intensity find किया. Now with the new value we will find out the load intensity W. We will find out the W on track load divided by LR into BE. So we have 25.62 kilonewton by meter square. Shear force VA equal to W into LR, LE minus X divided by LR. So VA equal to 25.68 into 4.76, that is 6.461 minus 2.38 divided by 6.461. We have the value of VA. Shear force we have 77.2 kilonewton. Dead load shear equal to WD into LE divided by 2. So we have 44.45 kilonewton. So total design shear equal to shear by the shear force and shear by the dead load. So we have 21.64 kilonewton total shear force coming in the section. Design for the deck slab. Effective depth required D equal to under root total moment. We have find out by the live load and dead load. We will add up of them and we will put here divided by Q into P. So D equal to 240. We have find out 240 into 10 to power 6 kilonewton newton per mm square mein change kara divided by Q equal to we have find in step 1 that is Q equal to 1.008 into 1000 B equal to 1000 D equal to 487.95. So value of T equal to 487.95 mm. Okay, this is not required. Now we will design for the reinforcement of the track or slab. AST equal to moment, total moment divided by sigma ST into J into D. We have these formula in the IRC loading for reinforcement and for moment and for depth. Okay, so AST equal to moment divided by sigma ST into J into D. So moment equal to 240 into 10 to the power 5, sigma is equal to 190 and J equal to 0.89 and D equal to we have 500. We are assuming this value 487 to 500 mm. So we have AST equal to 2838.55 mm square. So spacing we are providing 25 mm diameter bar, main bars we are providing 25 mm. Die of bar. Generally we are provide this die of bar in the slab of bridge. So we have 172.93 each mm each center to center distance or a spacing between the reinforcement. So provide 25 mm die of bar at the rate 170 mm center to center distance along the length of the span. Okay, now for the distribution reinforcement, bending moment for the distribution steel is moment of distribution equal to 0.3 of moment live moment and 0.2 is the dead load moment. So 0.3 of live load moment is equal to 169.9 plus 0.2 of dead load is 0.2 into 70. That is moment at distribution is equal to 64.97 kilonewton per meter. So we are using for the distribution bar 12 mm dia bar. So we have moment at distribution is 64.97 and using 12 mm dia bar. There is no need of that. So AST distribution bar equal to moment of distribution divided by sigma ST into J into D. We have to use here 64.97 into 10 to power 6. Now we have value for this 83342 mm square. Now we have to check for the shear tau V equal to V divided by BD. V the shear force and we have total shear force equal to 121 kilonewton and B equal to 1000 and D equal to 462.5 mm. So tau V equal to 121 into 10 to power 3 divided by 1000 into 462.5 equal to 0.26 newton per mm square is the tau V. Now percentage of steel equal to we have 0.528 from table and page number 76 of the code book, we will check for the tau c. So tau c value we have 0.30 newton per mm square. By the interpolation we will find out the value of tau c. Okay, since tau v is less than tau c, section is okay, shear reinforcement is not required, so we will not provide shear reinforcement. Okay, this is the reinforcement detail for the slab. This is curve which is 600 mm, 300 mm is the height of the curve and 500 mm is the thickness of the slab. This is the main reinforcement bar, 25 mm diameter at the rate 170 center to center distance, and this is the distribution bar, 12 mm dia, and this is the spacing at 150 center to center. Okay, this is the thickness of the bearing coat. So that's it for the design of the TEK solid slab.